Hello viewers and welcome to my channel. It's Leonard here from digitalleonard.com, and in today's video tutorial I want us to look at the difference between login password and a payment password in the CHY Mall platform. Now if you're new to my channel, consider subscribing and hit the notification bell to be the first to be notified each time new videos like this are published on my channel. Alright, so to jump right into it, payment password and login password. So let me go to my personal center here and let's go to register a new member. So if I go into my login to my network diagram here and I click on register, let me just click on this to open up the registration page. Now one thing you notice is when you scroll down here, there is a column for login password and there is a column for payment password. Now the login password, as the name implies, gives you access to your account. With the login password, you can log into your account, you can see every details on your account. But the payment password comes in play when you want to buy, you want to withdraw, any transaction that has to do either with buying, with sending, you want to send your points to someone else, you want to do P2P, you want to withdraw, you want to recharge, all of those things that needs either money coming in or going out of your account requires the payment password. So that is what you do with the payment password. The login password only gives you access to your account. So in this case, if you were not the one who created your account, in most cases people use different password for the vote. Some use a different password for login, which I would strongly recommend you do. Some people use do this only if you know you can't forget the password. It is becoming difficult now, so contacting support to reset your password because of people hijacking other people's account and the rest. So please, when you change your password, if you want to write it down, if you want to copy it and print it out and keep it somewhere safe. Don't come and rush to change password and at the end of the day you forget your password and then you start running helter-skelter. Once you forget your payment password, you cannot do anything on that until that password is reset. So please and please, because if you contact support now to reset your password, I think at the moment they are not resetting any password to further notice. So don't go and forget your password, don't go and change password and forget it and you start looking for a way to reset it. It will take some time before that is done, and if that be the case, that means no activity will go on your account until the password is reset or until you recover the password wherever you saved it or remember what you used. So payment password, once again, is used for all of your transactions on your account. If you want to withdraw money, before you withdraw the money you will need to put in a payment password. If you want to trade, before you can pay successfully for the product you are buying, you will need to put in a payment password. If you want to recharge, you will need to put in a payment password. So the payment password are used to do all of the transactions that goes on your account, whether you want to do P2P or whatever you want to do. For instance, if I want to transfer points to another person, once I put in the point I want to transfer here, I must put in this payment password before this will go through. If you don't put in the payment password, you won't be able to do that. If I want to withdraw, once I put in whatever I want to withdraw here, the amount and every details, I must put in the payment password before this will go through. If I want to buy from the CHY Mall store, let's say I want to place a trade, and I come here to the new retail or the wholesale, whatever product I click here, once I try to buy this product, I won't be able to buy unless I put in a payment password. So you need to put in a payment password to confirm that. Even if you are trying to upgrade an account, the payment password is what you use to do all of these transactions on your account. So login password, once again, is just to log into your account and see every details you have on your account. Payment password is the one that is used for the transaction itself. So I want to advise people out there, if someone has created your account and they gave you the password to access your account, please, if there is need to change your password, if you must change your password, please change it to something you can remember. Because support at the moment cannot reset your password for you. And there is no way to change password. There is no way you can change your password without putting the old password. So please and please, if you must change your password, be careful and write it down somewhere so that you don't forget the password or the login or the payment password. If you know it will be too difficult for you, you will mix it up. You can use the same password as both the login and the payment password. That way you'll be able to remember everything. And those of you who use phones, you use your laptop, anything you use, you can click on remember me. If you know you are the only one who have access to that phone, you know that nobody can carry your phone and then log into your account and withdraw your money, you can click on remember me so that each time you want to log in, you will have the auto fill of your password, filling either Chrome or whatever browser you're using, filling those details for you to be able to log in. So please and please, these are things that are very necessary. If you must create a password to protect your account, create a password that you can remember. And another thing I had to mention here is, if you are registering new people or you are trying to send people to register new accounts, let me go back to my personal center here again. Some persons find it difficult to create account with the CHY Mall platform. And that is because when you receive that pop-up that says it must be alphanumeric. Alphanumeric simply means your username here must be your name or whatever name you want to use plus some numbers. The same thing applies to the password. The password is equally, both the login and the payment password is equally alphanumeric. So it has to be the name of whatever you want to use as a password or the letters plus some numbers added to it. That is the only way you can scroll through this. So please and please, if you are sending links to your prospect to register on the platform, this is what you do. You have to tell them, if they don't do this right on the username and on the payment and login password, they will keep getting that required alphanumeric and the rest. And some persons don't understand that pop-up. So when it says alphanumeric, the username has to be the name in letters and then some numbers attached to it. And the password has to equally be the name and some numbers attached to it. I have to emphasize on this because some persons don't understand when the pop-up comes and says it must be alphanumeric. So please and please, if you want to register, if you want someone to register here, you need to follow these guidelines. So for instance, let me just put in some letters here and then put in some password. The password is not correct. Let's say password. Okay, it must be up to eight or there, but the password here must be up to 8 so that we don't get this different complaint. Let me just put in 8 here so that we get the right number. So one thing I've done here is I didn't put either letters or numbers with the password, and I did not do that with the username. So if I go ahead and click on register, just I click on agree and click on register. Okay, I have not selected this, so I need to select my country, Nigeria. And this is Niger, so go ahead and click on register. The password must contain alphabet and number should be more than 6 characters. So it must contain some alphabet. Now if I do that on the password, if I add some let's say I add password and some alphabet to the password, the next complaint you get is the username. Now if I click on register again, alright, please fill in the 6 digit plus alphanumeric number, alphanumeric member number. So all this one, now when you get this particular error, this is referring to the username. So I've been able to get that with the password, but the username equally must have a number attached to it. So if I attach a number to this username now, any number, if it is not taken already, you will be notified that if it is taken already, you'll be notified. But if it is not taken, it will just go through immediately. So these are things you need to send to your prospect. If they are the one registering by themselves, just tell them your username must be alphanumeric, the password must equally be alphanumeric. I hope you understand my explanation here. And once again, back to the payment password and the login password. If you don't want to lose your password, please don't change it. And even if you have to, be careful with the password that is sent to you. If you're not the one who created the account, you can print it and paste it somewhere. You can save it in your phone. Just save it somewhere. Save your password somewhere safe that you can have access to it. So basically, to protect your account, you need a payment password to be able to do all of the transactions in your account, and then the login password to log in to access your account. So where this comes into play is, if you want someone to log into your account and check some things for you or clarify you on some things, you can send the person your login password, the person log in and explain everything to you. Then whenever you want to carry out a withdrawal, you want to request for withdrawals, you want to recharge, you want to trade, all those ones now require payment password. You can do that yourself, or if you trust someone that can do that for you, you can send it to the person to do that for you. I hope this video was helpful. If it was helpful, please give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends on social media. And as I said earlier, if you are new to my channel, consider subscribing so that you won't miss out each time I publish new videos like this on my channel. And if you have any difficulty, if there is anything that I've not treated in this video, then leave a comment using the comment section below, and I'll definitely attend to your request. So until we see again in my next video, bye for now.